Hi folks, Silveretti One here again. I have a quick update on the recent James Turk interview. He's going over some other circumstances that might affect the price of silver. As you know, silver's in full backwardation. The current spot price, is 13 cents less at present than it is in backwardation out to 2015, the year 2015. James Turk was saying, "This is unbelievable. Money does not go into backwardation except in extremis. That means extreme conditions or extreme shortages. If this situation continues, there's no reason to expect that it is about to end quietly because the demand for physical silver is not abating. There's only two alternatives. The silver price has to rise in order to dislodge physical metal from the strong hands that now own it. But why would anyone accept some national currency in exchange for physical silver unless the price is much, much higher? Number two, the shorts declare force majeure and use government force to let them escape from their untenable position. The fallout from this outcome is very complex because there are so many factors to consider. But I would expect that any default would only strengthen the resolve of the strong hands now owning physical metal, meaning that the market for physical silver would become even more tight than it is now, even if the price shoots higher as I expect." Turk says, "Look for a short squeeze in silver already underway as evidenced by the backwardation to intensify as we move towards silver option expiry at the end of this month." February and March are going to be some awesome months for silver. Look for it. Silver delivery on March futures contracts in early March. In a short squeeze, what matters is ownership, not price. When you own physical metal, you are protected from government-sanctioned force majeure that bails out the shorts. The paper market for silver is losing its significance in the process of price discovery. What that means is it doesn't really matter what the paper market's doing. Silver is in backwardation. There's a shortage. So they're only going to be able to manipulate it for a little while longer. And then when the physical metal shortage really becomes apparent, look out. Everyone who owns physical silver should make their decisions based on what is happening in the physical market, not the paper market. That's what James Turk says. "A basic premise of precious metals is that silver leads gold, which is a point we have discussed before. It will be interesting to see whether the backwardation in silver will lead to a backwardation of gold. If it does, the end game for the US dollar is near. It would mean hyperinflation of the dollar is upon us." You know, the big banks have been flooding the silver and gold markets with paper for several weeks now, trying to keep the price suppressed. All they're doing is putting a temporary cork in the silver and gold volcano. Eventually it's going to explode, and when it does, everyone's going to be amazed at the price levels that silver and gold are going to achieve. You know, just remember that silver and gold are real money. They have been for over 6,000 years, and they have intrinsic value. You know, the value is in the metal. You know, if you have stocks or ETFs or any kind of paper currency investments, you have the possibility you could lose everything. In fact, you could even end up owing money with those types of investments. With silver and gold, that will never happen, not with physical silver and gold. It will never go to zero. It never has throughout history. Fiat currencies have. In fact, they all have at one point or another. Or they've hyperinflated to practically zero. So don't get discouraged with these short-term fluctuations. It's not really bearing on the paper market right now. It's all about physical, owning physical. Just stay the course. We're in it for the long term anyway. This is a long-term bull market. And when you've got a shortage, you've got nothing to worry about. Just keep on stacking. Don't forget to vote and subscribe. And I'll talk to you guys later. Take care.